I'm going to be at the Improv from 1 to 4:30. Meet and greet with the fans. Do a little comedy with them. I kind of incorporate the humor of the show with a little bit of just kind of other things, and just sit and hang out for a few hours with the fans. They love to talk about the show. They love to talk about the history. They love to tell me how angry they are at some of the characters and why aren't you with this person, and they know things about this show that in the last 45 years about now, that would just, you know, it would just blow your mind.
Does it kind of blow you away when, you know, I mean, because you've been with the show since, how long has it been now?
1996, but not for the entire period of time, but about almost over 7 years.
Does it kind of blow you away that people, you know, have such an investment in the show, maybe your character, that they're able to come up and tell you these things, almost like you're that person?
Absolutely. I think daytime is the only medium where they call you by your, they only know you by your character name. Nobody says, hey, Tyler, it's hey, Nicholas. And, you know, I don't know why that is. You know, I don't think you walk up to Tom Cruise and say, hey, Maverick. You know, it's Tom, or Crazy, or however you feel about him. But I don't know why that is. But so my conclusion to that is that they know you. They think they know you because they're in their living. You're in their living room every single day for however many years. So they 5 days a week. And they think they do get to know you. They know everything about you. They know everything about your character, who you've been with, you know, who you've been married to, who you've been divorced to. So it is flattering. And it's important to do things like this because, excuse me, without these fans, the loyal fans, you're not going to have a show that's on the air for 45 years. I mean, no show can really boast that. And doing things like this, I feel is important.
You're doing it at the Improv. I mean, does that mean? I mean, do you have an interest in comedy? Is that something that you're interested in? Maybe.
I've done it in the past year and a half in a little club up in Long Island, New York, and you know, people seem to like what I offered to the fans, and so I'm just going to try and spread it around the country a little bit and start here with it in Pittsburgh.
You think people will be freaked out by seeing you do comedy because your character, at least from what I understand, is not a naturally funny character?
Yeah, everyone's like, you're so quiet, you don't say much, and then I kind of get up there and my voice just gets a little louder, and people are surprised because, again, they associate your character with your own personality, and they don't often separate the two. So when they meet us in person and they see that we are different than our characters, they're a little taken back from it. And so hopefully they'll enjoy it here as they did in up in Jersey.
Well, one thing our viewers probably don't know is the fact that even though you're out in LA and obviously your show is national, you do know this area fairly well, the whole Pittsburgh, West Pennsylvania, Ohio area, because you grew up in Columbus?
I grew up, yeah, Delaware, Ohio, Columbus. It's just a few hour jaunt from here. And I had the opportunity to work on a film here back in 2000, a small little art house film called Out of the Black, and I spent about five weeks in and around the city, out in the country. It took place out in the country. I couldn't even tell you where I was. But I got to meet the people. I got to see the city. And it was when the stadiums were being built. So I saw the skeletons of that, which was pretty cool. And then I came back a couple years ago to check out a Steelers game on Heinz Field there, and it's just what a great place.
Yeah, what do you think of Pittsburgh? I mean, we're always interested to hear what people who aren't from here, especially.
Well, the stereotype. I mean, it's, you know, we all know it's an old mining town, or old coal town, right? And I think people associate that with a very blue collar. Not a place to go to get a nice restaurant, and I think that's the image that Pittsburgh has. And you come here, and maybe it was like that 80, you know, however many years ago, but it's just not like that anymore. The food's great here. I think it is, but I don't know. I could be wrong. There's some great restaurants, I believe, out there, and great places to stay. The hotels are nice. You know, love the river coming through the city. I like it.
Well, I'm going to ask you about something that might, I don't know, might blow your cover in the mind of General Hospital fans from Pittsburgh. But, you when it comes to your pro football team, you're not a Steeler fan. In fact, you like a team that Steeler fans tend to really dislike.
See, now you're going to get people aren't going to come to the show now, and I say, I'm a Browns fan.
They might come, but for a different reason.
Yeah. No, I grew up a Browns fan, an insane Browns fan. I remember being, I think I was 10 years old, when Beiner fumbled on the half-yard line, going into the end zone for the Broncos. And you'd never see a 10-year-old so mad. And I was banging on the floor, and I was screaming. My mom was like, come on, what are you doing? I was just that big of a fan, you know, back in the Brian Sipe, Bernie Kosar days. And when they took the team away from me, it just hasn't been the same since, but we're excited about getting Quinn in there and seeing if he can turn things around.
Finally, what's next for you beyond obviously General Hospital? Do you have other plans, other projects you're working on?
No, I do a lot of theater. Okay. In LA, I actually have a small theater that I'm a part owner of in Los Angeles. And when things go slow around the show, and they often do for everyone, I just pick up and do a play, and so I just have to stay busy constantly. I love to work all the time. That's probably not necessarily a good thing, but just the show. I'm with the show for the next 3 years at least, and whatever happens beyond there, we'll see. But if that's as good as it gets, amen to that.
Well, Tyler, hey, thanks for coming. Good luck to you on the 18th.
Thank you.
All the fans looking forward to seeing you. I'm sure they'd be happy to have them out there at the Improv.
Certainly. Thanks for having me.